It's really a stunning number. Wisconsin has lost 6,700 private businesses in just 3 years. What's going on and what do we do about it? I'll ask two former state commerce secretaries next on Upfront.
The president calls for an up or down vote on health care reform. Can House Democrats deliver? Upfront asks Congresswoman Tammy Baldwin.
We've got to rise at this moment, rise to the occasion, and pass the bill. We've come this far, and we've got to move this forward.
Is Tommy Thompson getting serious about challenging Russ Feingold? A former Thompson aide has the latest. Today on Upfront.
Honest, candid, insightful. This is Upfront with Mike Gousha.
Hello again, everyone, and welcome to Upfront. In an economy desperate for new jobs, the news last week that 125 good-paying jobs are coming to Milwaukee was reason for state officials to cheer.
Talgo will build its U.S. rail car manufacturing assembly facility at the Tower Automotive site right here in Milwaukee.
Governor Doyle and others worked for months to lure Spanish train maker Talgo to Wisconsin. Talgo followed Ingeteam, Republic Airways, and Mercury Marine in deciding to locate or stay in Wisconsin. But are these high-profile announcements overshadowing a troubling trend? Some new numbers suggest that might be the case. In a recent and little-reported study, the Wisconsin Taxpayers Alliance said Wisconsin has lost 4.3% of its private businesses in the last 3 years. The alliance looked at numbers from the U.S. Bureau of Labor Statistics and found that 6,700 businesses have left our state. Now, what's perplexing is that most of our neighboring states have actually seen their business numbers grow in that same time period. In Illinois, the number of private businesses grew nearly 8%. Iowa was up more than 2%. Minnesota had a small increase of less than 1%. Even Michigan, which has an unemployment rate much higher than Wisconsin, lost fewer businesses, with its 1.7% decline. So what's happening in Wisconsin, and what do we do about it? Today, we're asking two former state commerce secretaries. Bill McCoshen served as commerce secretary for Governor Tommy Thompson in the mid-1990s. He's now senior vice president at Capital Consultants in Madison. Cory Nettles served as Governor Jim Doyle's commerce secretary from 2002 to 2004. He is now a partner at Quarles & Brady in Milwaukee, and like McCoshen, he's a business person. Thanks to both of you for being with us today. We do appreciate it. Cory Nettles, I'll begin with you. What do you think we should read into these numbers? Because it is different than the first half of the decade where Wisconsin was outpacing the rest of the nation. What's going on?
Well, obviously, it's an area of concern. Anytime we're losing ground and our numbers are trending in the wrong direction, we ought to all put pencils down and say, okay, what's going on here? What do we need to do to fix it? I think part of what's happening is Wisconsin has been, for our blessing and now our burden, a manufacturing state, and we're continuing to shed disproportionately a lot of manufacturing jobs. I think that's really what these numbers show. We have to figure out how to pivot from that, shore up again, continue to shore up our manufacturing base while at the same time diversifying into some other areas of the economy where I think we have some competitive opportunity.
Do you see it the same way? Is it a function of the fact that we have been the leader in manufacturing, and that's been hit particularly hard in this recession?
No, I think it's more than that, Mike. I mean, the Taxpayers Alliance, those are a lot of small businesses we lost, 6,700 businesses more than any other state. And I agree with Cory. You got to ask yourself, why is that happening? Well, what are other states doing well to get those businesses to come their way, and what are we doing wrong to lose those businesses? And you know, I don't think we've done a good enough job in Wisconsin at asking those tough questions and coming up with serious answers on how to move this state forward. I think we're bordering on being back to the mid-'80s when Governor Jim Thompson of Illinois put the postcard in Kenosha that said, when the last business leaves Wisconsin, please turn out the lights. I think we have an image problem here, and it's incumbent upon our new governor in 2011 to do something about that.
Well, what do we do about it now? I mean, how do we confront the reality that we face?
Yeah, I mean, a couple things. You know, one, though these are small businesses, keep in mind they're small businesses who are suppliers to big business. Mm-hmm. So as go the fate of big business in Wisconsin, will go the fate of small businesses. Those things are connected. Part of what I think we need to do is we need to really step up with a new economic development strategy and plan for the next 10, 15 years. And we need to have a strategy and a plan that really focuses on our core assets, I think is important. And I think that's a non-political process of developing that strategy and plan. But then I think we need some very serious execution on that strategy. And that's been lacking. Every governor, every administration, Republicans, Democrats come forward with these plans, they put them on the shelf, and then they go back out to spreading resources around in a less disciplined, less strategic way. So not only do we need the plan, but there now needs to be greater urgency and focus on execution on the plan. And I think that's what we certainly have to be doing over the next several years.
Has that been the missing component, that we don't have a plan?
Yeah, I don't think we have a comprehensive plan, and we haven't for some time. I mean, when Cory was at Commerce, they did Grow Wisconsin. There were a lot of good things in there. When I was at Commerce, we had plans, but they weren't as comprehensive as they needed to be. Wisconsin needs that now. Competitive Wisconsin, the Wisconsin Economic Development Association, they're working on that. We should have something this summer that's similar to a project that was done in the mid-'80s, Mike, where it created a blueprint to move Wisconsin forward. And I agree with Cory 100% on the partisanship. Jobs aren't Republican or Democratic. I mean, this is something where both sides should be able to come together and move the state forward.
Right. But we have some really important questions that we have to wrestle with that relate to what economic development strategies actually work. And, right. You know, we're all throwing a lot of resources at things without a real clear sense of what works and what doesn't. That I think will come out of this study. The other problem that we've had is, as a state, we have significantly underinvested in economic development.
No question.
Think we need to come back and revisit that and decide that we're going to step up to the level of investment that you find in Illinois and Minnesota and Iowa increasingly. So I think that's going to be part of it. And then we really have to be disciplined. I mean, the challenge you have politically is, even when you have a strategy, all the other people who aren't part of the strategy are constantly leaning on you to invest in their project.
Right.
And to have the kind of discipline where you say, we really wish you well, but we're going to really stick to our knitting and invest in those areas where we think we have the greatest opportunity, to have the political will and discipline to do that is going to be an important part of execution.
Mm-hmm. Well, on the incentive side, I agree with Cory. I mean, Wisconsin's never going to be that competitive on incentives. We're not going to give $100 or $200 million for some big manufacturing plant.
And yet we've had some success recently.
We have.
With targeted incentives.
I mean, yeah. Mercury Marine, we saved Mercury Marine. A lot of credit goes to the county, to the state. I mean, there were a lot of players in that, but that could have been a massive loss for Wisconsin. Mm-hmm. 3,000 jobs going to Oklahoma. So we have to focus on the macro issues. How are we competing on the global tax issues, on the regulatory issues that bring business in the door in the first place? Cory, I think, would agree that incentives usually make the top five, Mike, but they're not in the top three. Businesses look at long-term economic situations before they make that location decision. Wisconsin needs to do a better job on the big issues.
You mentioned that, you know, should not be a partisan issue, but we're in the midst of a governor's race, and you're getting different philosophies on how we go about bringing new business to this state. Is it going to be possible to take the politics out of this, to come up with a comprehensive economic development plan for this state?
This is our first open governor's seat in 28 years, and I, for one, think it's a golden opportunity to get both candidates to focus on the number one priority of our citizens, and that's job growth and economic development. And hopefully both candidates, or major candidates, will come forward with comprehensive plans that people can rally around. They can at least see what they're going to vote on before November.
Couple of final points. Do we need to look at something other than manufacturing? I hear different views on this. Some people say this is an important part of who we are. It will be an important part of our future. There are others who say we're still too dependent on this sector for our economic well-being.
I think we'd be foolish to walk away from manufacturing.
I agree.
It's got to be a part
agree.
Of the strategy, but we need a more diversified strategy, and we need to be looking at water. We need to be looking at biotechnology. We've got a tremendous set of opportunities around people like GE. The water cluster that's developing here in our state is very strong. So manufacturing is an important part of our base. You know, you can't have people like Bucyrus and Joy Global doing the phenomenal job that they're doing,
right,
and say we're going to walk away from that. That would
right.
be foolish. But you can't have that be, you know, 75-80%, whatever the numbers are, of your economic development strategy.
Still an important part of who we are.
No question
Absolutely.
About it. I don't think we want to walk. That's part of our history and who we are. It's ingrained in the fabric of our state, and we got to continue to move forward. What we need to look for, Mike, is the next generation manufacturing.
Exactly.
Make sure that the companies we have are prepared to compete 10, 15 years down the road globally, not just in the U.S.
Are you bullish on the future of this state? I mean, I think if you look at studies right now, people don't feel that optimistic about the future in Wisconsin.
You know, the reason I'm bullish on it is, I remember when I was Commerce Secretary, I'm sure Bill had a similar experience, and it's confirmed with the move here by Talgo from Spain. We have some of the most productive, hardworking workers anywhere in the world.
Right.
And I think as long as you've got that kind of work ethic in our state, I think it puts us in a top position relative to some of our peers in the country and even internationally, and that's a heck of a thing to build on. We have tremendous assets with lake and fresh water. And those are some tremendous assets to build on. So I am bullish. I think we have tremendous opportunity, but we need to step forward and provide better leadership and better execution as the economy is getting tighter and the competition globally is getting a lot more difficult.
Well, very bullish.
I'll give you the final word.
I think economic development is going to be the top priority for the state for the next several years, and that's exactly what we need. The Talgo thing is a great announcement, but frankly, it's 125 jobs. Let's put it in context. Department of Revenue says we've lost 160,000 during this recession. You would need 1,320 Talgos just to equal the number of jobs we lost. So it is a good announcement. We want more of those, but we got to have a lot more.
We have to do the old focus like a laser.
Exactly
it seems
right.
like that's what everybody's talking
focus
about.
Focus and now. Execute.
Yeah. All right. Cory Nettles,
Thank
Bill
you.
McCoshen,
to
thanks
you.
To both of you
Thank
for being
you.
With us today on Upfront. Now, Milwaukee's gain with Talgo Trains was Janesville's loss. Talgo had considered the former GM plant before choosing the Tower Automotive site in Milwaukee. GM said last week it won't reopen any of its closed plants despite an uptick in sales. Just how serious is Tommy Thompson about running for U.S. Senate? We'll hear more from Thompson's former aide, Bill McCoshen, a little bit later on Upfront. But first, the end game for health care reform.
Can House Democrats accept the more moderate Senate health care plan? We'll hear from Congresswoman Tammy Baldwin next on Upfront.
Upfront with Mike Gousha, brought to you by American Transmission Company. We'll be right back.